Basics of Ladder Diagram in Relay Logic. If you're new to this channel, be sure to subscribe so you stay informed when new tutorials become available. By the end of this video, you should be able to read and understand complex ladder diagrams. Ladder diagram represents the electrical circuit in the control system. It makes it simple for the electricians and engineers to understand the control scheme. Now let's look at the elements of a simple ladder diagram. First of all, it is called a ladder diagram because it resembles a ladder. Secondly, the rungs are the horizontal sections of the ladder diagram that contain both the input and output components. On the left side of the ladder, you'll find the line numbers, like line 1, line 2, and line 3. On the left-hand side of the ladder, you'll see the electrical symbols for the input components. You can download a full list of these symbols from the link in the description. Sometimes design requires several parallel inputs. This is when two or more inputs will energize the same output. For example, on line 5 and 6, contacts R11 and R31 are connected in parallel. Output devices should never be connected in series. Doing so causes a voltage drop across each device, preventing them from functioning properly. Instead, they should be wired in parallel. For example, on lines 5 and 6, the water solenoid and alarm speaker are correctly wired in parallel to ensure proper operation. Finally, on the right, outside of the ladder, you find a short description of the outputs and if the contact of an output is used in another rung. For example, the information on line 4 shows that the contact from relay 1 is used in line 5, and the wire number is 51. Now let's look at other important elements of the ladder diagram. Input and output devices are wired between the hot and neutral lines. Output devices always appear on the right side of the ladder diagram, with one side directly or indirectly connected to the neutral. Even though the circuit will work, it is an improper design and not code compliant to connect the input devices to the neutral and output devices to the hot side of the ladder. A ladder logic system must include at least one fuse on the hot side, with its rating based on the calculated current draw. Before we dive into the ladder logic diagram for this press, it's important to first understand the key components that enable the press to operate. Let's review those elements before examining the diagram. The hydraulic press relies on a power unit that delivers fluid to the cylinder at a specified pressure. In addition to the pump and motor, a four-way three-position directional valve, when energized, directs fluid to the cylinder, enabling its up and down movement. The press also uses a solenoid-operated check valve as a safety feature to prevent it from drifting down when in the up position. The solenoid is only energized during the downward movement. Keep in mind, a real press has many other valves, like counterbalance and flow control valves that I won't cover in this example. Other key components include high limit pressure and temperature switches, a control panel that includes master control push buttons, an up and down selector, and two-handed palm switches. On the press, there are two proximity switches that indicate whether the press is in the up or down position. Now let's look at the press ladder diagram. The first section of this ladder diagram is the master control circuit, which you'll typically find in most control panels. The master control relay, MC, is a latching relay that powers the entire circuit once energized. In line 2, pressing the control on push button energizes the master control relay. This action closes the auxiliary contact MC1, bypassing the momentary start push button and keeping the master circuit energized. Additionally, when the master control relay activates, the MC2 contact closes, allowing control power to flow to the rest of the circuit. Also, you can turn off the master control power at any time by pressing control off push button. If you're unfamiliar with latching circuits, check out my quick video on the topic. The next rung in the ladder diagram controls the hydraulic pump motor starter. Like the master control circuit, it's a latching circuit but includes additional interlocks, a hydraulic temperature switch, and a motor overload protection contacts. When the start push button is pressed, the motor begins running. However, if the oil temperature exceeds a set limit, the temperature switch between wires 52 and 53 opens, breaking the circuit and stopping the motor. This temperature switch acts as an interlock. Additionally, the motor will shut off if the overload protection trips, which occurs when the motor draws more current than its full load amp rating. Let's break down the press up and down logic. First, auxiliary contact 2 for the pump motor must be closed, meaning the pump is running for any movement to occur. For the press to move down, the press down switch must be inactive, as indicated by the normally closed press down proximity switch. Additionally, the up-down selector switch needs to be in the down position, and the press should not have reached the high pressure limit, which is monitored by a normally closed pressure switch. If all these conditions are met, when the operator presses the two-handed palm switches, both the check valve and down valve solenoids will energize, causing the press to move down. The press will stop when either the down proximity switch or the high pressure limit switch is activated, which opens the circuit. For the press to move up, auxiliary contact 2 for the pump motor must be closed, ensuring the pump is running. The press up switch must also be inactive, as indicated by the normally closed press up proximity switch. Additionally, the up down selector switch needs to be set to the up position. Once all these conditions are met, the operator can press the two-handed palm switches, and the press will move up. The press will continue moving until the press up proximity switch is activated, which will open the circuit and stop the movement. Every relay logic diagram can be analyzed in the same way I've shown here, making it much easier to read and understand them. Thank you for watching, and if you like this tutorial, be sure to subscribe.